Folks, our break is done. Equipment check going on right now. Of course, the officials checking the players to make sure that they have all essential protective equipment, not only once again for their own safety, the safety of their teammates, the other skaters, the officials, and even the crowd. Just a reminder, if you're under the age of 18, you may not sit in the front row on the floor of the arena. Your safety is at risk. We want to make sure that everybody leaves here unscathed. So if you do happen to see a little one in the front row, please ask them to move back at least one row if you're on the floor. In the bleachers is fine because the boards will protect you up there. Once equipment check is done, we'll get started once again. Another 30 minutes of play. These teams have had a chance to talk, go over the first half, figure out a strategy for the second half.
Yeah, I'm imagining that both teams are going to change up their style a little bit in the second half, see what their collective coaching groups have suggested. Always interesting to see. I was just making Muppet faces at Nonstick Bam. We're getting ready for the first jam of the second half. We've got Tron lined up against Socrates. Tron pulls a quick move, picks up lead jam there. Deacon her way through the pack.
This is Socrates' first time up to jam in the entire game.
Clearly, Coach Cheese has some kind of new strategy for the second half for the Rebels. Lassies pick up a couple points there before calling off the jam. No points for the Rebels.
Well, if there's one thing I know about Cheese, it's that you don't want it to get too old. You want to try and change it up. New cheese is a good thing.
Absolutely. You don't want stanky old cheese. I have to say I'm a big supporter of Coach Cheese. In fact, I'd like to see him one day become Mayor McCheese.
That would be incredible. Finally catch that hamburglar.
Rubble, rubble. Lot of traction jamming for the Rebels up against Nonstick Pam, who makes her way through the pack and grabs lead jam. Susie Smoke Show giving a lot of traction the full ass. Four points there, picked up by the Thrash and Lassies, none by the Rebels.
I was in the arena.
Was it too loud?
No, it was fine.
And we got Nerdy Birdie lining up for the Rebels and Scarlet Mame for the Thrash and Lassies.
Between bouts,
Scarlet Mame actually got shot in the wrist, so that's why there's a bandage on her. That story may not be entirely true, but she does have a bandage.
And did you bring our levels up just a little bit in the first half?
Yeah, and Nerdy Birdie picks up lead jam for the Rebels. Scarlet Mame also threw the pack. And Nerdy Birdie punches a hole in and grabs two quick points before calling off the jam. 4 points picked up there by the Lassies.
Is that Scarla or Pam?
And Tron is lined up against Socrates.
This is Socrates, second time up to the jam line. Tron, of course, one of our main jammers in the first half, had 10 jams under her belt. This is her second in the second half.
Tron picks up lead jam. Socrates being tied up by that Thrash and Lassie's blocking line. One thing the Lassies really excel at is you think you're through the pack and you're one person to beat, and then all of a sudden there's a whole another person in front of you. Tron picks up 4 points, calls off the jam.
26 minutes and 25 seconds left to play in the second half. Thrashin Lassies now sitting at 156. The Rockyview Rebels at 38.
A lot of traction lining up against Nonstick Pam. A couple seconds ago, they were clearly embroiled in a vicious, vicious argument. And by that, I mean they smiled at each other and giggled. A lot of traction picking up lead jam. Nonstick Pam hot in her quads, though.
Second jam for both of these skaters in the second half.
And a lot of traction calls off a jam. 2 points there picked up by the Thrashin Lassies.
Twenty-five minutes and 30 seconds left to play in the second half. Jam 5 already down. Jam 6 coming up right away. Scarla Mame and Nerdy Birdie taking the jam line.
And Scarla Mame makes it through, picks up lead jam. Nerdy Birdie's still having trouble with that blocking wall of black. Lassie's blocking wall is really good at just sort of constantly shifting and always having people in the way.
Scarla Mame plowing into the back of that pack in corner 4.
And Scarla picks up 4 points and calls off the jam.
That 4 points brings the Thrashin Lassies to 166. Rebels at 38, 24 minutes and 7 seconds left to play in the second half. You might break your hip to the sound, that's legit.
I come to make a hit. I usually bust scratches from my brother CLC. And Socrates taking the line again for the Rebels. As I provide this slide, you're going on a ride. I know the weather's nice, there's no need to play the She's outside. Taking on yeah, Tron. Flyer, the man of your desire, Pete Rock, I see. Mickey Ficky forces Socrates inside, so she's got to cycle back behind her. And Tron got a minor penalty on that, so she does not get lead jam. So Socrates does pick up lead jam when she makes her way through the pack. And before Tron could do any damage, calls off the jam. Tron picking up 1 point there for the Thrashin Lassies.
I think Socrates wanted to try and catch up, surpass Tron, and edge out with points. Didn't quite pay off for her this time.
Same thing happened with Plato.
Now you're getting all philosophical on me.
That's what I do, man. I think, therefore I talk before I think. Susie Smoke Show lining up for her first jam with the Lassies today. She's up against a lot of traction. Smoke Show grabs lead jam.
That's one way to keep her out of the penalty box. Hopefully.
A lot of traction through the pack. Smoke Show grabs 4 quick points and calls off the jam. Great big grin on her face. Hockey Beaten now lining up. She's going to take on Nonstick Pam.
This is Pam's third time out to the jam line in the second half, one of those being a lead. Hockey Beaten's first out to the jam line in the second half.
Bit of a collision there. Pam saw an opening on the outside, made her way towards it, but unfortunately it got kind of pucked in and she wound up in a bit of a mess there. She's been called for a penalty, so this is gonna be a Hockey Beaten power jam.
Yeah.
Hockey beaten, punches her way through the pack, grabs 5 points for the Rebels. And Destroyer's making her way to the penalty box. I did not catch the call. Hockey beaten, dealing with the strong blocking of Anarchy and Mickey Ficky. Makes her way through the pack and grabs 5 more points. And she calls off the points. No points scored for either team in that last jam. She was trying to slip around, get those hips passed and pick up some points, but Mickey Ficky was having none of it.
20 minutes and 28 seconds left to play in the second half. 9 jams down. Nerdy Birdie and Scarlett Mame taking that jam line.
Scarlett Mame forced outside, has to go back to the back of the pack. That's going to let Nerdy Birdie pick up lead jam, but obviously Scarlett Mame not too happy about that. And Nerdy Birdie calls off the jam. No points scored that time, except for the emotional victory of knocking the other jammer down.
Yeah, Nerdy Birdie falling a little bit behind there after getting lead. Scarlett Mame put her off the track in corner two. Best decision to probably call it off.
Absolutely. We've got a 4-3 pack advantage for the Thrashin Lassies as Socrates lines up against Tron. Both jammers crunching away at the pack. Tron's the first one to break through, get that lead jam spot.
This is Tron's third lead of 4 in the second half.
And Tron finds a hole in the outside, grabs 5 quick points. The extra point for jamming lapping the jammer. And calls off the jam. Happy with those 5 points.
That was the first point scored in the past 3 jams, actually. Just those quick 5 and call off for Tron and the Thrashin' Lassies. 18 minutes and 22 seconds left to play in the second half. 11 jams down, jam 12 coming right up. Nonstick Pam and Gentilly Laced, first time out to the jam line for the Rebels.
Solid sockless blocking there by the Rebels, taking Nonstick Pam hard outside. Undeterred, she picks up that lead jam spot.
Gentilly Lace picked up a forearm penalty. That's why she's headed to the penalty box. She was so close to picking up that lead jam.
And of course, that does make this a power jam. Didn't see the call, unfortunately, but Nonstick Pam also making her way to the penalty box. That's going to free Gentilly Lace.
Pack holding in between corners 3 and 4, awaiting a jammer.
Gentilly Lace working her way around Ophelia Payne and Susie Smoke Show. While the Rebels' defensive line had tied up Sonya Blade. And Bloody Maiden called on a forearm. She's gonna head to the penalty box. Meanwhile, Smoke Show makes Gentilly Lace work for those, work to get back in the pack. Yeah. Sonya Blade on her way to the penalty box now.
No coaching the wrong team.
That was a scary moment. The smoke show went down. And Nonstick Pam went down over top of her, but made her way through, grabbed three more points for the Lassies, and called off the jam.
16 minutes left to play in the second half. The Lassies now up to 185. Rebels at 52. 12 jams in the pocket. Jam 13 coming your way. Scarlet Maiden and Hockey Beaten back out to the jam line.
Two very, very tough jammers.
Absolutely. Hockey Beaten is, she was 1-for-2 in the first half, 1-for-1 in the second half so far. Scarlet Mame has been out there three times, picked up lead one of those.
Scarlet Mame has come a long way in terms of her jamming style. She's learned a whole lot about not beating people up all the time and making the right choices. We're all very proud of her.
Maybe she spent some time at Camp Right Choice.
Absolutely.
In the summer.
Jam underway, and Rebel's line doing a good job of keeping Scarlet Mame tied up. Hockey Beaten, just a juggernaut out there. Scarlet Mame gets the lead jam. And it looks like Destroyer's heading to the penalty box. Scarlet Mame makes it through the pack. Grabs a handful of points real quick, 4 points, and calls off the jam.
As we approach the three-quarter mark, GM 13 is in the books. Nerdy Birdie and Tron heading out to the jam line once again.
Solid action in the pack. Tron picks up lead jam. Smoke Show trying real hard to force Nerdy Birdie outside, but or inside, sorry, but to no avail. Tron grabs 4 quick points, calls off the jam.
Both of those jammers have been forces to reckon with in this game. Many lead jams under their belt. Socrates now up for her 5th jam. Nonstick Pam, 5th as well in this second half. Official timeout has been called for some track maintenance. Great opportunity to thank a few friends over there in Vendors Village. Folks, make sure you go over and say hello to the folks from Underdogs Large Breed Dog Rescue, as well as the people from Crooked Seams Emporium, all sorts of cool handmade, hand-painted stuff. Go talk to Vamputee at Do You Bake, as well as Kalina over at Clever Cranberry. Pick up some jam over there, or South Hill Designs, Dames and Dolls Leggings, or Naturally Unique.
And again, we got Nonstick Pam lining up against Socrates. Nice hit on Nonstick Pam. I didn't catch who did it, but Rebel's blocking has been improved all this half. Nonstick Pam does manage to make through the pack and grab lead jam.
This is Pam's 3rd lead jam out of 5 in the second half.
Moulin Bruise getting a last minute hit in on Socrates there. Nonstick Pam picks up 4 points and calls off the jam.
A team timeout has been called by the Rebels. 12 minutes and 53 seconds stopped on the clock. Great opportunity to mention, of course, there once again, there is not an official after party for tonight, but there is an after party going on at Dickens Pub. $25 gets you into the Femme Fatale Carnival later on tonight. You want to join us down there. Dickens will be a hoot. Also, say hello to the folks from Dickens and the guys from the Extreme Dodge Beer League who are showing off their new game. Check them out on Facebook. They've got a cool thing going on over there, and they're happy to show you what's going on. In the beer garden, once again, everything is $5. Wild Rose Brewery providing the beer, cider, Palm Bay, all sorts of cool stuff. So if you're thirsty and are over the age of 18, can show photo ID, head on over to the beer garden and hang out with these folks down here. Not gonna lie, they usually have more fun than the people over there.
Well, I don't know, the Pouncy Castle's over there, and that looks like a rad time.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Scarlet Mame lining up against Hockey Beaten. Both jammers hitting the wall, quite literally. Susie Smoke Show forces Hockey Beaten to the outside. Scarlet Mame picks up lead jam. And Rebel's doing a great job of making Scarlet Mame work for it. Before she calls off the jam, grabbing those 4 points. Looks like Sanders Smash and 5 points, sorry. Sanders Smash and a lot of traction were called on penalties just before the end of that jam.
Minutes left to play in the second half. Jam 16 down and jam 17 coming up right away. We got Tron and Nerdy Birdie once again at the jam line. Let's see, Tron is 4 for 5 out of her previous jams in the second half. Nerdy Birdie is 2 for 4.
And Tron picks up lead jam. Nerdy Birdie with her hands full. Thought she saw a hole between Dazzler and Anarchy, and that was not a hole.
Glad she's okay, back up on her own skates, which is always a good sign. She will have to sit out a couple jams due to the injury. I want to make sure that she's okay before she gets back out there on the track.
Yeah, she went down hard right on the tuckus. And fortunately...
The tuckus?
The tuckus. You can't say other things for it on the microphone. Quickly taking a moment to instruct on our various other words that I could have used there. It's good always to know. I'm going to make some notes. Socrates lining up against Nonstick Pam.
Both jammers up for the sixth time in this second half. Nonstick Pam victorious once more. That makes it 4 out of 6 for Pam. Socrates with a cut track penalty is going to take the long way around the outside into the penalty box, giving Pam the power jam at this particular moment.
But Pam's definitely got her hands full with that Rebels blocking line. I believe that was Nylon Stocking who got called to the penalty box there.
No, that was a lot of traction.
Was it? Wow, I'm really good at this. If you're thinking about coming out and volunteering for the CRDA, they can always use smart announcers.
Or just people with, alertness.
2 feet in a heartbeat, you know. Nonstick Pam again pushing through the pack before calling off the jam and grabbing 4 quick points for the Thrashin' Lassies.
An official review as Coach Cheese approaches the center. Once again, folks, don't forget, if you are hungry, the food truck Bonito Burrito, it just kind of rolls off the tongue, doesn't it? Parked outside, serving delicious eats for your pleasure. We also have the canteen is here in Triwood Arena with all assorted snacks and other food and beverages. And don't forget about the CRDA bake sale in front of the Bouncy Castle. A lot of the league members put their own hard work and time into baking cookies, cupcakes, other treats and snacks. All that money goes to the league and makes sure that we can have events just like this for you. Speaking of supporting the league, there are 2 merchandise tables over here just to the right of the Bouncy Castle that have t-shirts, stickers, shot glasses, you name it. There's all sorts of stuff that you can buy to help support your own Calgary Roller Derby Association right here in your town. Make sure you head on over, chat with those folks, and you can ask them questions too, as Jim mentioned, if you're interested in getting involved. We'd love to have you join us and become a part of the CRDA. This is the last games of the season, so our next season will start up again in April or May, but getting involved now means that you get a chance to get to know the people, the league, and figure out exactly where you fit. I miss anything, Jim?
No, I think you did a bang-up job, Stay Puffed. Bang-up job. One thing I did notice as you were talking, however, is that they put the Bouncy Castle right by the bake sale table. So you can rile the kids up with sugar and then unleash them.
Function before fashion, my friend.
It's like babysitting Ragnarok. And again, remember to come on down to Dickens after the event today. There's going to be that Femme Fatale Carnival, which is going to be a red-hot time. Incredible burlesque and all kinds of stuff happening.
I think they have prizes and music and booze.
Booze.
And food.
Yeah, both things I like. Prizes and music, I mean. I don't eat or drink. Scarlamame taking on Hockey Beaten. Scarlamame picks up the lead jam. And it looks like Hockey Beaten called for the forearm. She's going to head to the penalty box and make this a Thrashin' Lassies power jam.
Scarlet Mame hanging on to that edge just before corner 3. Another 5 points up on the board for her.
And doing some of that one-legged fancy skating that the kids are all crazy about these days.
When I was a kid, I think we called that shoot the duck. I could be wrong, but that's kind of what it reminds me of.
Absolutely. So Scarla on that last run picked up 3 more points.
Hockey Beaten starting this next jam in the penalty box. That gives Tron the potential power jam position.
Or the PPJP, as we like to call it. And Tron picks up that lead jam spot. Makes her way through the pack and picks up 5 points. Hockey Beaten is, of course, back in the action. Punching away at that pack, seeing if she can't find a way through that dominating line Anarchy, Chrissy Cruisers, Sonya Blade, Mickey Ficky, all acting kind of in as one to just make it really hard. Tron's made her way to the penalty box, so this is a power jam for the Rebels. Sonya Blade making her way to the penalty box.
Sonya picked up a failure to reform penalty. That's why she's headed over there.
It's like reform school. Tron back in the action now and taking some big hits to get through the pack and pick up another 5 points. Looks like hockey beaten passed off the panty. So that's a change in jammer.
All right, looks like she's going to be okay. Have to sit out a couple jams. Getting some help off the track. But it's always a good sign.
A lot of traction lining up against Nonstick Pam. I'll tell you, those moments always, I can't really breathe that good when I see someone go down. It's really, really scary for me. Don't judge me.
No one's judging, Jim. It's okay. We can talk it out later.
We'll talk it out. We'll have a little talk therapy.
We have an announcer's support group that meets after.
We call it Announcers Supporting Surprises.
Maybe not the best name, but
yeah,
it works for us.
The acronym was really what we were going for.
6 minutes and 36 seconds left to play in this second half. 20 jams down, jam 21. Off to a good start, Nonstick Pam, the only jammer on the track. And picks up lead jam once again.
They call her Nonstick for a reason. Greases her way through the pack there with a couple of solid hits to make a whole 5 points picked up. Smoke show on her way to the penalty box. Again. And Nonstick Pam calls off the jam. just as a lot of traction was making her way to the back of the pack there. 3 points picked up by the Lassies.
Just over 5 minutes left to play. We probably got three or four jams left in this game. Not much more for the Rebels to try and close up that gap. 21 jams down. Jam 22 coming up. Scarla Mayhem and Nerdy Birdie, both returning jammers to the line. Nerdy Birdie's had two lead jams so far in the second half.
Scarla Mayhem picks up lead jam. Nerdy Birdie having finding a hole, picking her way through, and she's through the pack. Scarla Mayhem having some trouble getting through that pink wall, but just as I said it, she did it and calls off the jam after picking up 4 points. One point there for the Rebels.
Vill du höra hela historien med Ulrika Knapel?
And we've got Bloody Maiden for the Rebels taking on Tron. It's like I always say, you can't spell Tron without T-R. Tron makes her way through the pack, picks up lead jam. Bloody Maiden makes it through the pack as Tron does some smooth skating and pick up another 5 points for the, or 4 points, sorry, for the Lassies.
Three minutes and 24 seconds left to play in this second half. Folks, if you like what you're seeing and you want to give them that final boost as we approach the end of this game, don't be quiet, make a ton of noise for these girls. They've been skating hard for almost an hour. It's been scientifically proven that the louder they are, the harder they skate and hit each other.
Absolutely. A lot of traction jamming for the Rebels up against Nonstick Pam, who grabs that lead jam. And I can see the smile on her face. She likes the noises she's hearing. A lot of traction on her scoring pass. And looks like Nonstick Pam got called to the penalty box. That's gonna give a lot of traction a power jam. A lot of traction called for a cut track penalty, so she's gonna go to the penalty box, releasing Miss Nonstick Pam.
Waiting for the nod from the folks in the penalty box. Pam released there from the penalty box, back out on the track.
And Nonstick Pam picking up 5 points there. Coach Trailer Park Tracy bellowing encouragement at her. Five more points and a shiny new Deacon People out. And another 5 points there for Nonstick Pam and the Thrashin' Lassies. A lot of traction dealing with that crazy blocking wall. Christy Cruiser, Ophelia Payne, Mulan Bruise, Sonya Blade. Three more points there picked up by the Rebels. I'm gonna go out on a limb and say that was a whirly bird of a jam.
I don't know where that came from. We enter the final minute of play. This could be the last jam of the game. one or two more at the very most. A team timeout has been called by the Rebels, probably to plan their last strategy of the game. 24 jams down, jam 25 coming right up. Tron awaits at the jam line, one of the strongest jammers in this game. Easily half the points for the Lassies in the first half. Yeah. For the folks who don't know, we have a couple Lassies that are leaving the team after tonight, after this game. So this could be Tron's last jam as a Lassie.
That, this breaks my heart, honestly. Tron has been a massive addition to this team. Nerdy Birdie signing into the jam spot for the Rebels.
All right, jam 25 underway.
Tron picks up lead jam. Lots of solid action happening in the pack there. Nerdy Birdie gets through the pack. Tron picking up 4 points. Susie Smoke Show fouled out of the game. 4 points there picked up for the Rebels. And 4 points picked up for the Thrashin Lassies. Huge hit there on Nerdy Birdie by Mickey Ficky. That's really hard to say. Nerdy Birdie makes her way through the pack and picks up another 4 points. And a panty pass, so Mickey Ficky is now the jammer for the Thrashin' Lassies. 4 points picked up there by Nerdy Birdie and the Rebels.
Folks, the clock has run down to zero and we do not have a lead jammer. It means we're gonna run the full 2 minutes in this last jam.
There's 5 points picked up by the Rebels. Another 5 points for the Rebels, Nerdy Birdie. And that is the game.
At the end of 2 30-minute halves, our unofficial final score, Thrashin' Lassies at 297. Sorry, make that 300. They cracked the 3-century mark. Rockyview Rebels at 81. We'll wait for the official score before announcing that to you folks. Stick around. The teams are going to do a bit of a handshake. If you want to step out, put your hand out. They'll slap it for you. Folks, stick around for a little bit. During the break, once again, we're going to have a Zebra Says contest, kind of like Simon Says. Win some free stuff. So you want to stick around for that. Also, don't go too far just yet. The Lassies have a special announcement they'd like to make before you run away. Don't go too far.
announcements to make, guys. Two of our Lassies are leaving. This was their last game. So can we get Tron and Pam out here? Pam came to us first. She was a fresh meat. She was one of our first draft picks. Then she went and got knocked up. But after she gave birth, she came on back. And now she's going to get knocked up again. So this is Pam's last game. Let's hear it for Conception! Now, when Tron came to our league, she was a transfer. She was like a celebrity, okay? The training committee, which I was a part of, we were getting ready for fisticuffs over this one, okay? We were ready to fight to get her to be a Lassie, but it worked out perfectly. She just ended up a Lassie. We're gonna miss you guys so much. Tron, we're gonna miss you. We freaking love you so much. So, Lassies, we gotta get these jerks in the middle. And we're gonna do one final cheer with these guys in the middle, all right? Really loud! 1, 2, 3! Black Sharks, Dark Sharks, Thrashin, Lassies, make it hurt! Oi, oi, oi! I fucking love you guys. You've enriched our last hole so much. We love you. Thanks, Jim.
All right, folks. It is now the break in between games. I think we got about 15 minutes or so break before we start up the next game. Make sure you come on back about 7 to 10 minutes early. We're going to do a Zebra Says game, win some free stuff. So don't go too far. We'll do that in a few minutes. Thanks very much.